Good morning, students. Today we will continue learning about decimal fractions. During the last lesson, we were doing problem set number 39, wherein we were seeing how many rupees and paise was being converted into decimal numbers, which was given in the form of rupees. And we had also started with the relationship between meters and centimeters. So as you know, 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter, and when you convert centimeters to meters, what you have to do is divide by 100. So that means 100th part would give you the value of the meters. So let us have a look at the question number 5. We were about to do question number 4. Now in question number 4, they have asked us to express the meters and centimeters in meters and in the decimal form. So we have to find out how many meters in decimal form. So let us begin with the first question that is given here. 1 meter and 50 centimeter. Now, whenever you do sums like these, the one which is with the meter comes before the decimal, and the one which is with the centimeter would come after the decimal point. So in this case, your answer would be 1.50 meters. So in this way, the number 1 comes before the decimal and the number 50 comes after the decimal. Let's have a look at our second question. The second question states 50 meters and 40 centimeters. Following the same rule, we get the answer as 50.40 meters. That is, the number with the meters would come before the decimal point and the number with centimeter would come after the decimal point. If you look at your third question, which is 50 meters and 4 centimeters, here also you follow the same pattern. So you get your answer as 50.40. Now here there is only 4 centimeters, and remember when we had learned conversion, 1 centimeter was equal to 0.01 meters. So 4 would come over here, but before 4 you also have to write the number 0. Now the one of the way to remember this is 1 meter is 100 centimeter, so there are 2 digits. So remember that when you are writing it over here, there has to be 2 digits. And since there is only 1 digit here, you fill a 0 over here. This will help you in conversion. The next question we have is 734 centimeter. Now there are 2 ways of doing this question. Question number 4. Higher than 100, you can split 734 as 700 centimeter plus another 34 centimeter. As you know, if you convert them, 7 centimeter is nothing but 7 meters and 34 centimeter. So this again becomes similar to the previous questions, and therefore your answer would be 7.34 meters. Another way of thinking is 734, when you divide it by 100, that is 734 upon 100, because you're converting a centimeter to centimeter to meter form. So you can divide it by 100, and 734 upon 100 is nothing but 7.34 meters. It's either way you can understand this part. Either you consider conversion of centimeter to meter, so it would be upon 100, and solve it, or else split it up like this and solve it. It depends on you which method you would like to go for. Next one we have is 10 centimeter. Now, to convert 10 centimeter into meter, you have to write it as, this is less than 100, if you notice. So here how you get it is 10 upon 100 meters, which is nothing but 0.10 meters. So that means there are two digits, or else you can also consider this as, there is no mention of meters, so you write it as 0, and then there is 10 centimeter, so you write 10 after the decimal place, following the rule which we had learned before. So anyhow you can do this question. The sixth question is 2 centimeter. 2 also would be done in the similar manner, which is 2 upon 100. This will give you 0.02 meters. This is the answer. If you are finding it difficult to do it with this, what you can remember is there is no meter mentioned here, so you will write 0 in that place, and after the decimal what you're doing is there is only one digit here. So in one of the sums we had done wherein one digit is there, then you have to add a 0 to it. So you can remember it in this way and write the meter form. But exactly what you're doing is you're dividing it by 100, or writing it as upon 100, where your decimal fraction, and then you're converting it into a decimal number. So this is how we do the question number 4. Now we have finished learning about 1 meter and centimeter. So we know the relationship between meter and centimeter. Let's have a look at another relationship. The next which we are going to learn about is the relationship between 1 centimeter. Now if you look closely at a scale, you will see that each centimeter is divided into small 10 parts. Each part becomes a millimeter. So therefore, 1 centimeter is equal to 10 millimeter. And like how we saw earlier, 2 centimeter would be 2 into 10, that is 20 millimeter. That means if you go for conversions in this direction, centimeters to millimeter, you multiply by 100. Whereas you do the reverse. That means if I have to find out 1 millimeter is how many centimeters, I will write it as upon 10. So that will give me the answer as 0.1 centimeter. So what I want you to notice is, when we did conversions of meters and meters to centimeters, so then we had the two digit in the, after the decimal we had two digits. Whereas in this case, we have only one digit after the decimal. So this is very important. So let's have a look at sums based on these. The first question which we are going to do is question number 5. The first one. In question number 5, what you have to do is, you have to write how many centimeters and how many millimeters are formed when they give you the question as 6.9 centimeter. Now like how we saw in previous cases, the number before the decimal is the centimeter, and the number after the decimal is the millimeter. So in case if I want to split this up, this would be 6 centimeters and 9 millimeters. I hope you understood this. Now let's look at the second question. 20.4 centimeter. Again, the number before the decimal would be written as 20 centimeter, and this portion would become 4 millimeter. So this is how it is written as. Similarly, 0.8 centimeter, you can write it as 0 centimeter and 8 millimeter. But even if you don't mention this centimeter, since it is 0, you can directly write it as 8 millimeter. Next question, 0.5 centimeter. It is also similar to this question, wherein this will be 0 centimeter and this point, the one after the decimal point, is the millimeter. So here we will have 5 millimeter. So you can either write it as 0.0 centimeter, 5 millimeter, or you can write it as 5 millimeter directly. I hope you have understood this part. Now let's move on to the next part.
Understood this part of decimal fractions,
We'll meet next time and we'll be continuing with this chapter in our next lecture. Thank you so much.